Carlsbad Structure Plans for White Part 3. Today you're gonna look at the Finsbury Attack. It was something they played around 1900, and sometimes it still works today. It is Harry Pillsbury, American, well, it was probably not a grandmaster because I don't think they had that title back then, but a very strong player. He was creating fear among black players with putting his knight on e5 and putting the pawn on f4 and just attacking the king. And it's sometimes a very strong plan. And even though when we look at black's options in the Carlsbad structure, we will see how to what to do, how to deal with the Pillsbury approach. But it's something you should always be careful of, because when it's good, it's very good, and you just get. Okay, let's start with the game. This will be a short video. We are in the year in 1900 in Paris, and it's Harry Nelson Pillsbury against George Marco, who was not a bad player. And it's the Queen's Gambit, and they start off with a normal Queen's Gambit, you can say. And here he plays the, well, you could call it the accelerated Tartakower racing, but no one had heard about Tartakower in 1900, so we probably should call it the Fianchetto variation, or even the Marco variation. This is usually black plays h6 and bishop h4 and then b6, which is known as the Tartakower variation. Another option is knight e4. Bishop d3, and here he takes, and here black should probably take with the knight. Would probably have been the best option, and just take back with the bishop and play something with c5. And here white went knight e5. By the way, this is the Carlsbad structure. Usually we look at it with the pawn on c6, but it is the Carlsbad structure, and it also arises in the Tartakower variation. And one of black's plan against the Tartakower variation is actually to go b6, and in against the minority attack is to go b6 and c6 and answer b5 with c5. We will get back to that later in a later video. Knight e5, knight bd7, maybe not the best move. Black should start to be attacking this square. This is the weak square in the Pillsbury attack, and you want to attack it. And we should notice that when white is doing this, because here it is, this is the Pillsbury attack. And we have actually probably seen it a lot with white recently in some semi-Slav, where it also makes sense to play this way. And it is very dangerous. So white has easy an easy attack on the king side, and already this knight is very strong. And if you take it, you will open the f file here. So this is something you should be careful about. Usually black should be able to defect this knight or play around it, and we'll get back to that. C5 cannot be bad. Castle, but the next move, c4, I don't like. This is very typical of ancient chess, where I play my plan, you play your plan, and let's see which plan is the strongest. The problem is that white's plan is the strongest, so he definitely should not have played this move. He creates a majority on the queen side, and in an ending it could be quite nice. The plan is very simple: get the pawns rolling, and maybe someday capture this square when you get rid of this knight on c3. I'll just make it red like this. But before the ending, God put in the middle game, and this will be dangerous for white, for black. Already here, we are seeing some things that black has to be careful. He has to cover there. That's fine. Okay, queen h3. There is already a serious threat in the position. White is threatening to take here. Oops, and I didn't do that right. I'll just show you. No, don't do that. And if black takes back with the queen, comes, because this knight is suddenly overextended and must cover everything, and the king will have to go back, and bishop f5 and winning the queen. So there is a serious threat in the position already. D6, covering the threat, but of course f5. White is having all the fun, all the pieces are joining the attack, and this is the part of the Filsbury attack that is just, and this, well, courageous, but of course, maybe not at the moment. The big threat is probably g6 and g7 and take on f6 and mate on h7. So you have to take back. Queen h4, just putting more pieces into the attack. Take here. Queen takes and rook takes. And we know that if he takes back here, he didn't do that, then this mate is very, very impossible to defend against, even if this queen was a rook. Instead, he played a5, hoping for something with maybe rook a6. The other rook comes in, rook a6, and here comes the check. Boom, threatening mate here on h7, has to take, and this shows that even in 1900, they could really play chess, actually. They were good, because he takes here, and it's actually mate in 5 moves. We should see it. You have to take back, otherwise it's queen h6, check, check, right? So check, and what now? Here, and you have to go king f8 and lose the queen. Here, this is mate, and here, this is mate, and of course, this is not mate, but it's hopeless, and actually it will be mate very soon with these moves. So this was Harry Nelson Filsbury with a great advertising for the Filsbury attack. He won a lot of games with this, and you can look it up in Chessbase. It is great. Look out for the next episode about the Carlsbad structure, which will feature White's central attack with e4, without the preparatory f3, e4. Thank you for watching.